Ableton finally announced Apple Silicon support. I found a nice email in my inbox from Ableton. It said live 11.1, now in public beta, Apple Silicon support and more. Ableton has been late to the game adding Apple Silicon support, so for them to finally be making progress on this is big news. So right now there's only a beta version that offers this support, but you can download it right now from Ableton if you join the beta program. To do that, you just have to sign up for an account with Center code, and it's pretty straightforward. And once you do that, you get access to download this live 11.1b3 release. That's the current one right now. I'm sure they will be releasing more versions as they continue to test the beta. So let's go ahead and try it out. So I made a set to test out the capabilities and push it to the extreme. Okay, so we have a track here, and then I have a couple of MIDI tracks with some VST instruments on there, and then a whole bunch of extra audio tracks, total of 100 tracks on this project. And then on the master signal chain, we just have a whole bunch of effects loaded in just to see what this does. So let's just play it. So everything's running smooth. So yeah, 35, 36%, 37%. On activity monitor, we're at 117, 111, and it's running smoothly. Now all of these tracks, they do each have audio in them, but they are all the volume is turned down, so you can't hear it. It's handling it really well. What else could we do to make this more challenging for the system? How about we just take every track and double it. Twice the amount of tracks, and let's do twice the amount of plugins, of effects plugins, see what that does. Okay, so now we have twice the amount of effects plugins on the master. We're at 75% on the CPU with the overload meter on, but it's still running smoothly. Let's go check activity monitor. Looks like it's at 230% now on the CPU and still 11% on the GPU, 13%. So it's going up a little bit, but it's still running pretty good. And this is also at 128 samples buffer size. It's running good. This is actually really impressive. Let's go back to the current version of Ableton now that is running on Rosetta and see how it compares. So this is live 11.010, and we're just gonna open up a set that I did that is pretty much the exact same as the one we just tested. Twice the tracks again, and then let's double the plugins as well. So this is just a lot going on. Our CPU is 75. Pretty consistently, it hit 80 there for a second. Our activity monitor is 222% GPU. So it's interesting, there's actually less usage on the GPU with the non-Apple Silicon native version of Ableton. And the CPU is actually similar. So right now, there's actually not much of a difference. It's running smooth. I don't honestly notice a difference at all, really. As they optimize the beta and continue to add more stuff, it's probably going to get faster. And also by the time they release this to the stable releases for Ableton 11, it probably will be more improved. I think this really shows that the M1 Max running Ableton with Rosetta are actually doing a really good job. Nonetheless, I'm really glad that Ableton's finally adding Apple Silicon support. I look forward to them fixing all the bugs, and then we can finally get the stable release of Ableton 11 with Apple Silicon support, hopefully pretty soon. And it might not be a complete game changer, but even just a little bit of performance boost is nice to have. So you can go see for yourself, download the beta if you want. One nice thing about downloading the beta that is that you can still have both versions of Ableton installed. So you can have the new 1.1 beta, and then you can also have the classic Ableton. And they don't, if you work on a project in the beta, you can't open it in the normal release. They are very separate. And so really, I wouldn't work on any serious project in the beta, but it is fun to just play around with and trying to get used to it. Otherwise, wait for the stable release to come out and enjoy it then. Best of luck to you and your music creating journey, and create every day.